Plants require key nutrients in order to grow. These nutrients are not always available in the soil. Potassium is one of these key nutrients. Potash is a potassium-based fertilizer often used for plant growth. We used it in our experiment to manipulate the level of potassium in the soil. Potassium is known to help regulating the uptake of carbon dioxide by plants.
The purpose of our experiment is to determine if potassium is a limiting factor in the growth of the angiopogon genus. We hypothesize that the lowest concentration of potassium will yield the greatest growth for the angiopogon glomeratus species.
We measured 5.22 grams of potash for the lowest concentration of potassium and increased it by a factor of 2 for each medium and high concentration. We filled 9 9-inch square pots with topsoil that did not contain any other nutrients. Potash was added and mixed in, and the seeds were added, covered, and then watered.
The control is 4 to the right, and as you go to the left, the levels of fertilizer, which is potassium, increases by a factor of 2.
We are testing the effects of different levels of potassium. The control does not have any potassium. The low group has 5 grams of the potassium fertilizer. The medium group has 10 grams of potassium fertilizer. And the high group has 20 grams of the potassium fertilizer.
After a week of growth, we begin to see the potassium precipitate out of the soil. We believe this is because of soil dryness. The results of our experiment came back inconclusive because what we thought was growth was not actually growth.
The Andropogon genus experiences low variability in its nutrient requirements. It is often the dominant grass in low nutrient soils due to its ability to live with less nutrients. Its tolerance for low nutrient soil has been seen in its ability to get by using minimal amounts of nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium.
One study done by Moser and Anderson showed that nitrogen seems to increase the yield of Andropogon and its crude protein content. However, the increase of crude protein in the Andropogon due to the addition of nitrogen was not large enough to be of practical importance. Nitrogen still seems to be a limiting factor in this genus, but it does not affect the growth after a certain point. This can also be seen with phosphorus. A study was done by Gerloff to show that the yield of Andropogon increased as the concentration of phosphorus added increased from no phosphorus added to 5 parts per million, but there was no significant response to further phosphorus increase. Potassium works for plants that require more sunlight to grow. Plants that have leaves that are used to better gather sunlight experience better results from increased potassium. A study done by Sideris and Young involving pineapple plants showed that the leaves of high potassium cultures were longer, wider, and consequently possessed a greater area and weight than those of low potassium. It is still unclear how potassium will affect the Andropogon genus, but from what data has been collected by scholars, we can infer that potassium has a minimal effect on growth. And if there is a correlated effect, it is minimal up to a point, similar to that of phosphorus. As stated previously, Andropogon has the ability to live in low-nutrient soil. In a study done by Saletti and Knapp, nitrogen fertilizer was added to plots that led to an almost tenfold increase in soil pools of integrated nitrogen. However, Andropogon was not significantly affected by fertilizer, which leads us to believe that nitrogen is not a very limiting nutrient. There is no significant evidence that claims this genus is limited by potassium. However, there is evidence that Andropogon is limited by nitrogen and phosphorus and very low concentrations. We believe that potassium could be a limiting nutrient for Andropogon, but we can infer from research that it would have not affected growth significantly. The results of our data came back inconclusive because the Andropogon was not growing enough, but we believe that this genus represents the tolerance model of succession because it's able to grow in areas that lack nutrients in their soil, nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And research other than our own have showed that the Andropogon is the most dominant grass in areas that lack nutrients or soil nutrients, which leads us to reject our hypothesis saying that potassium concentrations will affect the growth.